Greetings, fellow Oathlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are going to address the very first quick mission, or rather, as I would like to call it, an independent scenario in today's video. This particular mission is called Six of Fun. It takes place in Central Asia. 1,000 lights. No, I don't really. Okay, 10 o'clock in the morning. 1,000 hours. Right. So, yeah, all of these missions, there are like 20 in total, and all of these missions are independent of each other and of the main campaigns. So these are literally just missions that you get into and get out. There's no real storyline to them, except for, you know, the story that's presented to you, the situation that's presented to you, rather. Nerve gas armed movie SCUD missiles have been identified in your area of operation. Locate them and destroy the launches before they can be used. And that's pretty much it. I wonder if I have any final mission authorization for this mission.
A U-2 overflight has identified several mobile SCUD launchers believed to contain nerve gas. These launchers pose a serious threat to neighboring troops and civilians. An airstrike is out of the question because of their location behind enemy lines. You are ordered to locate and destroy the SCUD launchers. Bravo will insert south of the target area and destroy the launchers using satchel charges and artillery strikes. Artillery is limited, so choose your targets wisely. The area is heavily patrolled and the final target is inside the opposition's main base, so stealth will be required for success.
Now, I was thinking I could probably pick the sniper for this. However, from the looks of it, yeah, there I can see four SCUD launches here, right here. There's 1, 2, 3, and 4, and there's a fifth one right here. And I'm not certain whether I would have 5 artillery strike authorizations in total. Of course, I would seemingly have to rely on the satchel charges and laws. I think so. So with that in mind, and the fact that this terrain does not have a lot of sniper cover to, you know, facilitate a long-range encounter, I think I would be better off taking... Okay, they are recommending the sniper. I thought I would be better off taking the... what do you call it? The M4 instead, but if they are going to recommend the sniper, alright, let's go ahead and take the sniper then. Although with the M4 grenade launcher, I could probably take out at least one of those with like 5 or 6 grenades. Do I perhaps want to try it out with this? Because there aren't a lot of enemies on this mission. Let's see.
Ooh, Bravo, sorry. This is King 6. Intel confirms several SCUD sites in the area. Take them out. Bravo, this... watch for patrols along your route.
This sort of reminds me of the area where the submarine surfaced in Mission Whiteout, if I'm not wrong. And we're on our way. Now, it's been a bit of time since I played this game, so I'm hoping that it will not be too harsh on me. What is that? Is that just a tree? Nope, that's the first SCUD launcher. Well, that's another SCUD launcher right there. And there are some enemies over in that area, but before they come, I would just like to...
This is King 6 requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Fire mission is on its way. The problem is I need to hold the target until the fire mission actually arrives. Thus far, I have not been compromised yet. And I would like to keep it that way. There are some folks over there, from the looks of it. They still don't know where I am, so I would like to keep it that way.
This is King 6 requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
That you carry satchel charges, it's typically the case that the law is not powerful enough to destroy whatever needs to be destroyed. Because I remember trying to destroy a MiG in this game with laws. Realistically, it should have been taken out with just one shot. Because I think laws are meant to be used against helicopters. In either case, it should not have been as difficult as it was. However, by the time that I was actually able to take anything out, I see another SCUD launcher there. Let's just go ahead and mark it for demolition.
King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
Yeah, I was sort of suspecting that they would only be like... Actually, I do have 5 artillery authorizations, artillery mission authorizations. The enemies are unaware of me at this point, and I would like to keep it that way. That's destroyed. So are my frames, but yeah. The target is destroyed. Here we have a Danger Coast mission authorization.
This is King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, send your fire mission, over.
I don't know where the other guy is, but I could not see him as he ran past me. So I'm guessing he's most likely behind that hill over there.
Bravo, this is King 6. Area secure, move on to the next target.
Roger, King 6.
Bravo, this is King 6. There's a patrol to the west along your route. Stay quiet and avoid contact.
Roger, King 6. I shall attempt to do exactly that. Just some bomb stars. Now, while I would like to get up on top of this hill and go around this entire place, let us try that. Let me try doing that. I saw those guys over there, but I do not want to alert them to me or my presence, especially since things have been progressing so well thus far. That's a dead guy. Even though it might be a little slow, let me just go ahead and try and run up this surface here. And we are sliding down, of course we are. But maybe I could hook over around the back. Perhaps. I'm not certain. Maybe it could work. I just hope that the game does not give me a warning saying you're leaving the mission area, or it doesn't drown me in the water. But short of that, we should be cool with everything else. I actually don't really see many negotiable pieces there. Maybe we could go there, go around by that side. It should give us like some sort of cover, to be honest. I think that face is more negotiable. I could be wrong, of course. Doesn't hurt in trying, I suppose. Doesn't hurt to try. Now, this ice here, I could probably climb up this side, couldn't I? No, I don't think I can. Yeah, it's difficult to climb up this side. Took a way more roundabout approach than I originally intended to, but oh well. Whatever works, I guess. Whatever works, as long as it does work, that is. At this point, I do believe there's only one more SAM site remaining to be taken care of. And I do have the artillery authorization for it as well. But if it fails in the rear instance like it does, all we can do is essentially just... So I'm here. Where is the final... Oh, it's all the way over there. Well... Suffice it to say that I'm way off target here. I took a little too large of a roundabout, it seems. Yeah, I can't climb there. Can't climb there either. Let's try up ahead. Maybe we can climb someplace up ahead. Or not. Everything seems pretty much fixed. Oh yeah, right here. We can probably get to the top using this face. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. So, one of the things about Delta Force is that it's an open world game. Every single mission scenario, no matter whether it's a campaign scenario or it's an independent scenario like this, puts you on a map that is essentially an open world. And they provide you with the sandbox approach to essentially, well, do things as you see fit. So you don't really need to do something that you're not comfortable with doing. Like, you don't really need to follow the objective markers all the way to the end. You can instead just ignore them altogether, like I am doing, and figure out a better path for yourself. Now, being a stealth gamer, I mean, I'd like to be stealth in games, so this is sort of thrilling for me. I don't know about how it might be for you guys, but I like the way this game is playing thus far. Now, I wonder if I have to actually head to extraction after all of this is said and done. And if I actually have to get over onto that cliff there to find the final site. Yeah, I suppose I do. We need to head north. Alright. Heading north then. What is that? Oh, that's the Comstar. The communications array. So that is where we need to go, and that is where we will go. So one of the things that I think they could have done better with this game is some background noise. Like, for example, since this is Antarctica, or wait, this is Central Asia actually, but anyway, since it's so snowy, one of the things that they could have done is, okay, there are two SAM launches there. Oh well. Oh well. I guess we lease the first one for detonation, and then we go in and blow up the second one then. Or maybe we blow up this one first. I think we'll blow up the one closer to us first, because there are more enemies around it.
This is King 6, requesting fire mission, over.
King 6, Whiskey 1, request denied.
Why? Oh, right. I don't have any more fire mission authorizations. How though? I guess the laser designator does not work like the rest of... Well... Like the rest of the weapons in the game. I think 5 grenades might just be enough to take out one of these things here. But yeah. You never know. Because in order to take this particular one out, I will have to get into like a proper firefight. So, if it comes to that... Let us try taking it out with our grenade launcher first, and then we can try and circumvent the entire area and light the other one on fire. How far is this? 170 meters? I think this should be good enough in the elevation. Shot. I can't tell if I'm hitting or not. Have it your way. There's a bullet for you. I have a bullet for you. Two, actually. Another bullet for you. Another bullet for you. And another one for you. Come on, stop running. Thank you. Another one for you. Another one for you. And who else is there? Who else wants some spare bullets? I've got loads of spare bullets. Who wants them? Do you want? Yeah, take it. It's a free bullet anyway. Feel free to take it anytime you want to. That guy's dead as well. Anybody else that is eager for some bullets? Well, I tried taking it out from my grenade launcher, but apparently that doesn't work. And somebody else is shooting at me. I can't tell where they're shooting at me from, but somebody else is shooting at me. Maybe I will have to retry this mission here. can't see. Ah, there you are. I was about to say, can't see anybody there. And then the guy just reveals himself to me. I hear another guy somewhere over there. Can't see him though, but I do hear him there. I'm taking way too much fall damage. The next fall can kill me. I don't really mind retrying this particular mission again though. Not a lot of resistance to be honest. And this is sniper. You guys have a sniper with you. Of course. You would obviously be in the sniper tower with me. I thought I saw somebody there, that's why I'm shooting out all the windows. But I guess it was not. I don't really have any reason to do so. Making my way down, I don't really see anybody else. I just need to tag that thing and get out, and that's it. Blow it up with the satchel charge. I tried using the grenade launcher, but of course it did not work. This is going to be a little risky. So, let me just hide here until my frames return. Did they come back? Yes, they did, apparently. There's a Hummer there. Can't really see any more enemies though. I just want to quickly check around this building once. And there were folks there, they're all dead now. I feel like I'm exposing myself a little too much here. But over. Nobody here. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna be... Wait, there is a gate here. I was about to say I'm just gonna do it. Sorry. Not bad. I'm gonna blow a hole through the fence, but... Yeah, turns out there's already a gate there, so we don't really need to do any of that. See another enemy. Do these guys really just spawn? Yeah, they did. They did literally just spawn. Right out of nowhere. So, I'm gonna get close to it, as close as possible. If I see the guy that ran over from that side, I'm gonna try and kill him. But if I cannot, I'm gonna... Well, if I don't see him, my plan is to just drop a satchel charge here and move. I don't plan on sticking around. No. The satchel charge. Yes. Thank you. And my plan is just to move away from this area. Now, where is the enemy? I wonder if I already killed him. That would be nice if I did. But, yeah. I don't think there are any enemies behind me, but... Somebody up top? Oh, somebody over there. Right. Sometimes when this game says that... You might need to use your own satchel charges. Sometimes it's true. Sometimes it just is true. I see another enemy. I hear someone far closer to me. Just gonna go to the moon. I think the shots are coming from somewhere over there. But then again, I could be wrong. I guess. Oh, there you are. Best strategy in this game, if you're getting shot, just lay prone. And a satchel charge for you. Okay. Time to head back behind some cover. And blow this shit up. It was going fine. The mission was going really was going fine until,
well,
we ran out of satchel charges. And duck, not impact grenades, no, detonate. And that's it. We didn't even have to head to extraction or anything. Alright. All Scud launches armed with nerve gas are destroyed. King 6, Bravo 1 is out to be over and out. And that was like a pretty simple mission, 6 of 1. And I hope that the rest of the quick missions are just as kind and nowhere near as complicated as some of the latter campaign missions tend to be. Because my god, those are hectic. This was actually enjoyable for a change. So not too stressful, but still challenging enough to be entertaining. So yeah, I think this would be like a peak Delta Force movie for me. Next up is Stolen Goods. Now, as for today's video, Mission 6 of 1, this is it. Thank you for watching, thank you for tuning in, thank you for sticking around until the end. Next time we come back, we will be covering Stolen Goods, which is apparently yet another night mission, but I think we will be equipped with night vision goggles this time around. So, yeah. I don't know whether I got lucky with 6 of 1 or not, but, or maybe I just played it smart, but yeah, it felt pretty easy and entertaining to me. So, pretty tactical as well. And I had to risk it a little bit too, so I'm quite happy in the end. Also happy with the fact that I did not die of fall damage. Anyhow, the next time we come back, we will be covering Mission Stolen Goods, which takes place in the Middle East, somewhere in the Middle East, let me tell you where. So, I wonder, do they ever tell us exactly which country this is taking place in? Europe mountains, yeah, South America, Middle East, just the continent, so they don't really get into the specifics of it. Oh well, alright, I guess these are classified missions as such. So, yeah, the next time we come back, we will be covering Mission Stolen Goods. Until then, take care. Fare thee well, fellow orphans.